Hello and welcome to a brand new edition of Film Room, unlike anything you've ever seen before. Thanks to the miracles of technology, no longer am I standing in front of a TV, I'm actually standing inside of it. If only you could see some of the magic that Jalen was able to pull off in this studio, you would understand how high tech this production has become. I'm very excited. It's a new decade, it's a new show, it's the same old nerd inside your computer screen. I thank you for following me along on this journey. Today we're going to talk about numbers and calculations. Just kidding. We're going to talk about Kristaps Porzingis' ability to space the floor and make an impact on the offense, especially Luka Doncic, without even having to touch the ball, and how his addition into this offense has really kind of changed the way that Luka can play, and it's opened up other opportunities for his teammates. So this is really important stuff. It's going to be very nerdy, but we're watching film, so this is some real basketball analysis. So right off the top, give a little bit of background information. I'm sure you're aware the Mavericks right now have the number one offense in the NBA in terms of points scored per 100 possessions. They're one of the most efficient offenses of all time, and really the only significant addition that they've made to the roster from last season in terms of guys who are playing like more than 15 or 20 minutes a game is Kristaps Porzingis. You have guys like DeLon Wright, Seth Curry, of course, coming off the bench, making an impact in their own way, but it's KP that's really kind of opened up driving lanes for Luka and passing lanes, which has led to some really easy offense for the other big men on this team. I'm going to show an example from the Lakers game recently where KP is not even going to be involved in the play. He's just going to be standing on the wing, but his presence on the floor is going to lead to an easy layup to Luka Doncic. His presence on the floor is going to lead to an easy layup for Luka Doncic. All right, so what we're going to do is I'm going to play the whole play first, and then we'll go back and watch it and do the whole detail, like inspired breakdown. That's totally not a knockoff of detail, by the way. Kobe, we were doing this in 2016, man. Okay, so on this play, I want you to watch Luka. Just watch the ball. So Dwight Powell's gonna come up and set a high screen for Luka. Luka's gonna drive the lane and lay it in. It looks like a pretty standard play that doesn't even involve KP. It's just Luka and Dwight Powell, right? Like KP's not even involved. But this time, we're gonna break it down a little bit, and I want you to watch what KP does. So Porzingis is gonna come across to the wing here. And when he does, his man Kyle Kuzma follows him. Now there's kind of this like weird sort of miscommunication almost between JaVale McGee and Kyle Kuzma right here. I think they both thought that the other was gonna pick up Powell, so they're both stuck to Porzingis. But of course, McGee is the primary rim protector for the Lakers. You have Anthony Davis down in the corner worried about Dorian Finney-Smith. So it's up to McGee to stop dribble penetration and a potential lob pass to the big man. Meanwhile, Kuzma is gonna be paying attention to Porzingis, but watch what happens when he does. So Luka turns the corner here. Go back and rewind it a little bit. Luka turns the corner here, and Kuzma's just watching him drive by. The reason is because he's attached to Porzingis. Look how close he's playing Porzingis. Of course, he's one pass away, and so your job as an NBA defender is to play the guy that's one pass away. You want to encourage skip passes, take away the easy ones. But what you don't want to do is roll out the red carpet for one of the best rim drivers in the game to get an easy layup. So Luka turns the corner, it's automatically a 2-on-1, there's no help from Kuzma, and all of a sudden it's an easy layup for the Mavericks. So 68 players in the NBA this season have taken at least 100 shots off of drives to the rim. That's from NBA stats. Luka is number one among them in field goal percentage. He's shooting 62.4% on drives to the rim. The next best player in the NBA by field goal percentage is Giannis, who I think we can all agree is very good. He's shooting 58.8%. So Luka is significantly better than the number two guy in the league, and a lot of that is enabled by Porzingis' rim spacing, or floor spacing. Of course, rim running has something to do with it as well. Dwight Powell being on the floor certainly helps matters because you're turning it into a 2-on-1, and that's where Porzingis' impact is really felt later on. So let's watch this play one more time, and then we'll go on to the next one. So again, watch Kuzma. He's making a very difficult decision saying, all right, I'm out of the play. He's automatically removing himself from the play, which lets Doncic get all the way to the rim for a layup. So next, we're gonna talk about a double drag. So basically, the Mavericks run this, it's called 77, but they run this double drag action where you have both Porzingis and Dwight Powell setting a screen for Luka, who can come from one side of the floor to the other. And what that does is, whenever you have two guys setting a screen, it means that you can't switch the screen because you're switching and then switching again, and oftentimes defenses don't have two big men that can switch on to a smaller ball handler. So teams like the Warriors in the finals, for example, a few years ago, whenever they were going head to head with the Cavs, you would have someone else guarding Kyrie, right? So then whenever Kyrie would set a screen for LeBron, they'd switch off. Or you'd have someone else guarding LeBron, so whenever LeBron would set a screen for Kyrie, they could switch that. If you involve an action with only two guys, if you involve only two guys in an action, then it's very easy to kind of switch it and junk up the offense. But what this double drag screen does is it forces three defenders into the situation, and oftentimes there's going to be either a miscommunication or you're going to put yourself to an advantage as the offense because the defense is going to be unprepared. So let's watch this play in real time. So Porzingis and Powell come over. They're both going to set a screen. All of a sudden, again, it's a two-on-one, and Luke is going to lob it up to Dwight Powell. So Dwight Powell obviously is a very, very good rim runner. He's been one of the top rim runners in the NBA for quite some time now. And also, of all of the players that have set at least 500 screens in the league this season, there's 58 of them, I think, maybe 48 of them. There's a lot of them. Powell scores the most points per possession. The Mavericks score the most points per possession coming off a Powell screen than any other team does with any other player in the NBA. And a lot of that is because of Luka, of course, but also KP. So you saw Luka get into the lane, flick up the lob for Powell for the dunk, but this is why it's important. So watch what Porzingis' presence behind the three-point line opens up for the Mavericks. So Porzingis sets this first screen here. So now it's Trey Lyles and Derek White in the play. But of course, Dwight Powell's lingering over here. LaMarcus Aldridge is right next to him. And these guys are smart. The Spurs are well coached. They know exactly what's coming next. So Derek White is gonna go over this Porzingis screen. Trey Lyles sags off, but watch what Lyles does as Luka takes the Powell screen. He doesn't move. He's not moving at all. The reason he's not moving is because if he leaves Porzingis, he's gonna give up an open three and he's gonna get benched. So what that does to the defense now is suddenly it's Derek White and LaMarcus Aldridge on Luka. And look at all this real estate Powell has to roll into. Now, Aldridge sniffs this out and he backs up, but by then it's too late. But the reason that Powell is able to just have this free run to the rim as the roll man is because Trey Lyles is not moving. He's just standing still. Again, he can't leave Porzingis. His last season in New York, Porzingis shot 39.5% from deep, shot even better on catch and shoot threes. He's one of the league's best three-point shooters, got limitless range. Even when he's standing 30 feet from the rim, you have to pay attention to him. You have to respect his shot. And when you do that, the Mavericks can turn essentially a two-on-two play into a three-on-two play. You have Porzingis totally eliminating Trey Lyles from the situation. And no matter what Lyles does, as we'll see in a second, whether he commits to KP or commits to helping his other teammates, he's already lost because he's either giving up a wide open three or an alley-oop dunk. It's all about forcing the defense to make a difficult decision, essentially, is what the Mavericks are doing every time down the floor. So this is another really good example. This time, you know the drill. Watch what Kyle Kuzma is doing. I'm not trying to pick on Kyle Kuzma, but this is obviously a very difficult matchup for him because he's at a size disadvantage. So Luke is gonna come off, take this handoff, and again, it's a two-on-one, and the same thing happens. This shows it from a different angle, what we just watched against the Spurs. Kuzma is hugging Porzingis over here on the sideline, on the weak side of the floor. If he leaves to tag Powell, Luka can zip it right over to Porzingis for a wing three. That's easy money. But he doesn't. He stays glued to his man. So look at all of this real estate. Luka has the entire paint. Nobody is in the paint except for Dwight Powell. So he's got an enormous window to throw the ball into. And of course, Powell is a very good roll man. He's got good hands, big explosiveness. So he's able to go up and catch this and lob it and throw in the lob. Kuzma does eventually help out, as we see, but it's more like token pressure. The only way that he's going to be able to make a play on that pass is if it's a bad one, and Luka doesn't throw bad lob passes. He's so late to react to the situation because he doesn't want to leave Porzingis. He knows right now that Powell is rolling to the rim. He knows exactly how this play is going to end, but if he takes a step 1 second too early, Luka knows exactly what he's doing, and he's going to be able to find Porzingis for three. So it's not only Porzingis' floor spacing ability that opens this up for Powell, it's Luka's passing ability too. That's what makes this duo such a dynamic force on offense, because Porzingis commands defensive attention, just like we saw from Dirk for more than two decades, but you also have Luka, who's one of the most skilled, talented passers in the NBA. He's got incredible vision, 360 degrees, he can see what everybody is doing, and he always plays two steps ahead. So when you combine Porzingis' ability to command attention with Luka's ability to see the floor and Dwight Powell's ability to roll the rim, and also Maxi Kleber has done a very good job of that as well this season, you can really unlock a lot of really good options on offense. So this is a really good example of all of those factors in play. It's Luka's dynamic ability to pass the ball and drive, attack the basket, It's Porzingis' ability to space the floor, and then it's Dwight Powell's ability to roll hard and fast to the rim, make the catch and finish. So this is against the Pistons in Mexico City. The Mavericks in this game had been having huge success with the pick and roll. You saw all the highlights of Luka throwing the lob passes to Porzingis. You also saw, I think it was later in the game than this, but you saw Porzingis make a catch off a pick and roll that he wasn't involved in, drive the lane and finish over Andre Drummond. So this was probably the Mavericks' most dominant performance in the pick and roll all season, or at least certainly of late. So in this play, the Mavericks are kind of running a different action. You can't even see Porzingis on the screen right now. He's buried down in the corner. But what you're going to be looking for is, well, I'll just show you first. How about that? So the Pistons right now, you can see here, Blake Griffin is down here guarding Porzingis. Luke Kennard is down here guarding Dorian Finney-Smith. The Mavericks are again turning this kind of into a three-on-three at the top of the floor, but they're going to soon involve Porzingis. So watch what Luke Kennard and Blake Griffin are doing. As the play is developing, Blake is pointing and Kennard is pointing. See that? Kennard pointing, hey, saying, come over and help, come over and help. He's signaling for Blake Griffin to slide over. But then watch what Blake Griffin is doing. Blake Griffin is signaling for Luke Kennard to come over. Meanwhile, neither of them moves, and Powell has an easy dunk. Now, who messed up? Well, based on the way that Luke Kennard is reacting here, I think Blake Griffin might have messed up. Based on the way that Blake Griffin is reacting, I think Luke Kennard might have messed up. What happened here is, as we said before, you never want to leave your man who's one pass away from the ball. So Luke Kennard, now I don't know the entire rule set of the Detroit Pistons defensive system. Dwayne Casey's a great coach. I'm assuming that they had a plan in mind for what's going to happen when the Mavericks run a pick and roll with Luka and Dwight at the top of the arc. But what you're doing is forcing the defense into uncomfortable positions. Luke Kennard is a shooting guard. He's kind of a combo guard, 2-3 guy. He's not a rim protector. Blake Griffin is a power forward. Theoretically, he's the guy that should slide over. Also, he's two passes away from the ball. Luke Kennard is one pass away. Right now, as Dwight Powell rolls the rim, Dorian Finney-Smith is like 15, 20 feet away from Luka. And so you're thinking, if you're Kennard, you can't slide over to help on Powell, because not only are you at a tremendous size disadvantage, I mean, look at the size difference. Powell's like 4 or 5 inches taller than Kennard, but also if you leave Finney-Smith, you leave a guy wide open for the wing on three. However, Blake Griffin down here, who's signaling for Kennard to slide over, knows he can't leave Porzingis because Luka is doing this no-look thing. You never know where he's gonna throw the ball whenever he's about to make a pass. So he could be staring at Blake right now, saying, hey, whatever you do, whatever decision you make, I'm gonna beat you. If Blake does slide over to help against Powell, Luka can fling it over to the corner to Porzingis. If Blake stays attached to Porzingis as he does in this play, Luka can just drop it off to Powell for an easy dunk. And everybody is frustrated after that play. Look at this. You have frustration, frustration, frustration. Tony Snell's not even trying to take the ball out of bounds. Like, the Pistons are done with that possession. They're like, man, that was a bad time. We're not having any fun right now. We're in Mexico City. We're having just a terrible game. This sucks. So these are just a few examples. Obviously, there's been thousands of plays that have involved Luka and Porzingis and Dwight Powell and Maxi Kleba and shooters like Seth Curry. I mean, there's been 34, 35 games of sample now. But this is a pretty good example, in my opinion, of the value that Porzingis provides, not only as a guy who can shoot, but also just simply as a floor spacer. It's kind of an abstract concept. It's very difficult to quantify if you're into numbers, or to explain if you're just into the eye test, the value of a guy simply standing still, right? Just commanding defensive attention. But this is my attempt, at least, to give a few examples to show Porzingis's ability as a teammate. Just simply standing there makes things easier for his teammates, especially Luka, who's having an MVP caliber season and was not last season. Luka's shooting, like I said, better than 62% on drives to the rim this season. Last season, he was shooting worse than 49% on drives to the rim. And again, there's only really been one major change that's happened to the team this year, and that's the addition of Kristaps Porzingis. So I know that he's struggled in the post. I know you got people on national TV demanding that he get as close to the rim as possible and be a big, strong guy and show what he's all about, but him standing on the perimeter 25 feet from the basket has led to a lot of wide open looks for him, and clearly it's led to a lot of wide open looks for his teammates. The Mavericks, again, have the number one offense in the league by far. They're on pace to have one of the best offenses ever, and a lot of that has been unlocked by Porzingis' ability to space the floor and to shoot from anywhere. So thank you for watching. Hopefully you learned something. Technology is amazing, as Jalen just proved. Hopefully we'll be able to do this more often. Because they don't seem to be slowing down anytime soon. There's going to be a lot of good basketball to talk about between now and the rest of the season. So, what should I say? Thanks and have a good day. Go Mavs.